All right, guys, so we are in the truck. We just got done with John's testing up here, and I decided to get a what are these tunes called?
This is called a remote tune.
But a tuner's here.
No, I'm not a tuner. I'm a tune-up. I'm a tuna, baby.
I like the tuna here. No one likes a tuna here. Yeah, well, I do.
But when you have a ride-along tune, I think it's called something different.
So look, so Courtney's truck, I hopped in. It smelled like he'd been drinking pina coladas up in here. And that's what I'm singing. I like pina coladas. I can't sing at all. But Kelly's, I'm going to get home and Kelly's going to be like, why you smell all fresh in there?
Oh, yeah.
I usually smell like race cars. Now I'm getting covered up in the...
Well, see, when you do the salvage cars, as soon as you move into a house, you clean it.
Right.
So when you go through as many trucks as I do, when you move into the truck, you like clean the piss out of it.
Is this a salvage truck?
Oh yeah.
Oh wow, this is nice.
Oh yeah.
Is it for sale yet?
Not yet, but it might be this week.
Soon.
Anyways, that's not what this video is about.
But sorry for the sidetrack.
We're going to go ahead and do the tune on this car. So we've got to make the tunes, and I don't 100% understand what needs to be changed. So I figure we'll film it and take y'all along real fast on what he's going to change. We're coming off of M1 with a Procharger, and we're going to turbo. So we're keeping the M1. We're keeping the same cool pack. Basically, what you need to look at and change if you're coming off of a blower setup and then you're going to turbo. With the turbo, we added the back pressure, and then we added dome pressure. And then we also changed from 3-bar to 5-bar. All of that's low dollar sensors. So we'll see. We'll dive in and see what we got changed.
All right, guys. So the biggest thing. So there again, I'm not a tuner. I'm not a professional tuner at all. So the biggest thing, the biggest change, a Procharged car, when you give it gas, the blow-off valves close and you get instant air, right? So generally, there's a couple things you need to change in the fuel map. And I'm not going to really change this a ton, because until the car is running, that's when you'll really modify it. So think of this AE versus TPS rate of change. Essentially, what this is your squirter if you had a carburetor. If you have a fuel leaker, this is your squirter. So if you have air instantly, sometimes this number would be a little bit less. Now that's a pretty small number, but now he's got this little Coyote motor, so it's only 300 and some cubic inches, so it's not a ton of cubic inches, so it doesn't have a ton of fuel. So we're not gonna really mess with this. The fuel in itself, when you get into the base table, down here is where you're gonna be, right? So from zero down into these cells, this is where you're giving it gas, and you see that some of these numbers are a little jacked up, and that's just from where we've been playing with it. So like that one right there is a 51 right here at 1600 RPM, and you know, it's still showing all red. If you go into a large table, actually, I'm not going to do that, because if you go into a large table, basically, excuse me, basically what happens if you go into a large table is you get a whole lot more cells, you get more resolution, but we're not going to go in there. I'm going to take these, though. I'm going to take this number right here, and I'm going to just get it in line with these. I'm going to drop that one down to like a 40, and then that's not that big of a change, and that's kind of where it's going to be. It's going to be in here. What, you know what kind of vacuum this motor pulls when it's idling?
No, I've never even looked.
Because, you know, down here at minus 12, minus 10, it's not going to be there. So it's going to be somewhere in this minus 2 to minus 4. It depends on how big the cams are, and it depends on a few things like, how high the engine is idling. When you have more vacuum, you'll be in these cells. But so really, honestly, I think what we need to do, Courtney, I think we need to not mess with this right now, because the car cranks up and runs good right now. Mm-hmm. And when it's idling and the blow-off valves are open, it's essentially like a turbo car, right? Because think about it, the turbo is not spinning, it's just sucking in the air that is naturally aspirated. It's not making boost, it's not doing anything crazy. Now, one of the things, remember when we sped the blower up that one time and we only had one blow-off valve?
Yeah, we did.
And we had to go in here and put a lot more fuel in.
Yep.
Because the blow-off valve was not venting. You didn't have enough, so it was consuming more air. And so we had to modify it. So since then, though, we've modified this table back to get it back to where it's good now. So I think we should leave this table the same. So the biggest thing, what we got to do.
We got to do the 5-bar.
We got to do 5-bar. And okay. This is, I just took a picture of this. And so this is where it gets real important. And so let's look at this real fast. So let's say you're at 22 pounds of boost here. So 22 pounds of boost, and at 7,800 RPM, it's 25.45 pounds of fuel, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's 22 pounds. So right here. So when I change this to 5-bar, what's going to happen? This scale right here is going to stay the same. This scale over here is changing. And I don't remember if the zero actually changes or not, but it may. So we're fixing to find out. Basically, 5 bar, this is going to go up to 60. In this same small scale, I don't know why Holley does this. All EFI may do this. To me, it would make sense that it would say, okay, well, 30 pounds, let's just move that to the 30-pound line. But that's not what happens.
So when we go from a 3 bar to 5 bar, what are we doing? Just gaining measurement, basically?
You lose resolution.
Lose resolution.
Because now, instead of going from minus 12 to 31, it's going to go to like minus 12 to like 60. So you lose resolution. Now, there's a lot of people that, you know, they'll take, there's a couple of things. Some people say, okay, well, let's give more vacuum. So they'll give you more, like, instead of having 2, 4, 8, 10, they'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6, and then that's it. Or maybe it'll go down a little further. And they shrink up the boost area. And some people say, well, no, we need more resolution up here in the boost. I'm not a professional tuner, so I don't know. So I usually just leave it kind of how it comes.
We'll let Kevin handle
tuning. That's right. But essentially what we're going to do, so let's go to that 2,200, 2,500 pounds of fuel at 76. Horsepower is horsepower, right? So when you have a turbo that is making 2,000 horsepower, it's going to use a little bit less fuel than a supercharged car making 2,000 horsepower. And the reason why is because of the parasitic losses of the supercharger. The supercharger is going to take more horsepower to turn. Damn. So you say, oh, I only made 2,000 horsepower, but the motor thinks it, the motor actually made more horsepower than that. The motor made 2,200 horsepower. So up here in these fuel maps, which Kevin will tune all this up when it's on the dyno, he'll probably end up having to take fuel away. So at that 22 pounds of boost, at 7,600 RP or 7,800 RPM, it'll probably end up at like 2,300 pounds of fuel.
So, Will, on the turbo, the car is not going to burn as much fuel, or it's not going to be noticeable?
That's right.
Because it was drinking fuel with the Procharger.
It's still going to drink fuel. It's methanol.
Yeah.
But it's going to drink less fuel.
A little bit less fuel.
But it's not going to be noticeable to you.
I got you.
Still going to be going, I got to put fuel in this thing again. That's, I can promise
But it technically is using less fuel.
It is using less fuel, right. Because it's not at 2,000 horsepower. Is at the wheel, the Procharged car uses more horsepower.
Gotcha.
At the motor.
That makes sense.
So that's what, you know, it's a little bit of a difference. But the biggest thing, so right here, when I make this change in a minute, when I go from that 22 to 78, that 25.45, let me show you what happens. So he's got this saved as M1. So the first thing I'm going to do, we know this is a good tune. I'm going to take file, and I'm going to do a save as file.
Label it turbo.
Yep, that's exactly what I was going to do. And then we're going to go into global files, M1, and this is turbo. So now
we don't jack up our old.
That's right. If I screw this up real bad, we can go back to the other one, and then we can look at stuff. And sometimes I'll pull both screens up, but sometimes you get, you know, a little confused. So first thing, you got to go into the sensor, and then you go into map, the first one that populated. He's got this offset in here. We'll just leave that in there. That'll probably change. And the Holley 5 bar is just a drop down.
It's a low dollar.
It's a low dollar.
Low dollar PSI.
Did they give you the map resolution?
I can look it up probably.
Okay.
You want me to look it up real fast?
Yeah, look it up real quick.
All right,
guys. So he just looked it up. Low dollar motorsports. If it was a Holley one, you just drop it down. And so we did custom map here in their description. It tells you right there what it is. This is a minus 14.5 PSI. To 58 PSI. And then this is the key thing, is it shows you minus 14.5 is 0.5 volts. And you see the standard voltage that come up from 0 to 5. So that's not gonna be accurate. So we want this first one to be 0.5, and we want this last one to be 4.5, right? So now we do that, and then we come through here, and it is linear. If it was not linear, they would tell us. And then we're gonna fill these row values. So now we have 0.50 to 4.5, minus 4.5 is correct, and then this one up here is now 58. So what we have to do is, there again, we just go in there and scale it, right click it, fill row values. What is 120 still in there for? Okay, let's try it again. Okay, there we go.
That's where the not professional tuner comes in.
That's right. That's where that tune
that
up.
Disclosure.
That tune
that
up.
That you sign at the beginning of this.
That's right. All right, so we're good now. So now, minus 14.5 PSI, so 1 bar that way. And that's what a map sensor is, 5 bars, 1 bar in the vacuum and 4 bars that way. So 4 times, I thought it was 60 though. No, maybe it's not. No, that'd be 5. What's 14.7 times 4?
Right, I'm a high school dropout.
Oh my goodness, look at there. Mathin is mathin.
So I guess technically that would be 58.8, but in their paperwork they say 58.
They just cut out the 0.8.
Yeah, that's right. So it's close enough, right?
Mm-hmm.
Close enough. We're playing horseshoes and hand grenades. All right. Accuracy, 0.5 through the whole scale. And that's probably just like the Holley. The Holley 5-bar, I probably could have selected it. It probably would have been the exact same. Okay, so a minute ago, it asked me when I clicked on that, do you want to change everything? And the answer was yes. And so I'm going to go in here, and I save this stuff periodically. So we're going to save it real fast. And so then we're going to, okay, cool, I'm done, right? I'm done. Well, no, you're not done. That actually, look, that since I hit custom, remember that 130 was first thing up there?
Mm-hmm.
So now, I wonder why that didn't automatically calculate to the one that I put it at. Because 130 is gone. You would have thought that would have populated. Hold on, let's just see something. Holley 5-bar. That's your error. Let's see if it puts it.
So when you put the 5-bar in there, technically it should update the fuel.
Yeah. See how it did?
Yeah.
It changed it to 60.9. So the Holley can read a little bit higher. But okay, regardless, we're gonna go back to the custom one because we know you got a low dollar, and that's fine. The low dollar stuff is absolutely fine. So let's go back to the custom. Ooh, 1 bar. We're gonna make vacuum. So let's change that to custom. See if it, I guess because it doesn't say custom 5-bar. It's just got custom map. And I guess that's why it does the 130 minus 14.5. Let's do this again. So 58. And then we're going to grab this and fill it again. Look, it did it again. I wonder why.
And you had them all highlighted.
Maybe that one was highlighted by itself. Okay, so that's right. 0.5, look, that stayed the same that time. 0.5 to 4.5. Okay. So let's go down through here. Let's go back to the fuel one. Yes, it is still not changing. No problem. 58 minus 14.5. And we're just going to fill this in. You see how, like, this has got good resolution up here?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's so close, but that's not where we're going to be. Because we got to fill it. All right. Boom. Cool. Awesome. So now, at 58 pounds of boost, this fuel map did not change. So the fuel map did not change at all. None of these numbers changed. What would have been nice is when you say, okay, we want to go to 5-bar, that it would have said, okay, well, I know that this one, and maybe there is a way for this to happen.
Yeah.
It would have been nice if Holley would have took this line up here in the top and said, okay, cool. This line up here was our 22 pounds. Let's move it down to that 24 pounds right there, just a little bit. And so, boom, okay, but they don't do that. So look, so if you just do this right now, what do you think is gonna happen to your engine when you go wide open throttle for your first pass?
Yeah, that's over my pay grade.
You're gonna blow it up. It's gonna be so lean. Actually, it may be lean enough to where it may not hurt it. Because look, so now at 24 PSI, at 7,800 RPM, it's gonna have 1,600 pounds of fuel.
Okay, so that
that's 1,000 pounds. That's 500 horsepower less fuel than what it should have. It's going to be so lean, it's not even going to be funny. So this is where it gets funny. So what I need to do, so it gets complicated. I'm not a professional. We know we have a little bit less fuel. This is the line right here that was the 22 pounds, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now it's at 43 pounds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this. Actually, I'm going to cut it. I'm going to just cut it out. Boom. Zero. Boom. Are you crazy? What happened? So now I'm going to paste it right here in that 24. So I'm going to paste it. So now that one line right there is now accurate, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now this zero has also moved down. So the zero before, so remember I told you to take a screenshot of this. Or a picture. I took a picture of it so that I can revert back to my pictures.
To the table.
So there's my fuel table right here.
Mm-hmm.
So I took a picture of the map. So we're gonna zoom it up real big because I can't see and I ain't got my glasses on. So zero was at your 41 to 28, so 41. So that was zero. So now that right there is at 9 PSI. So again, that is gonna be way, way, way lean, right? Way lean. So that was zero. So all I'm trying to do is duplicate a couple spots here. So I'm gonna cut it and I'm gonna paste it right here at zero. So now that's zero. So now, if I take these, so before we had a lot more, it went down to minus 12. So it was zero up here, and we only had three lines here. So minus 14.5 we didn't have, so that was minus 12. Okay, so we're gonna just take this right here, and now minus 4.8, we're gonna use 14, 23, 51, that was minus 2. So this one was minus 2 on this 4.8. So I'm gonna cut it, and now it's going to minus 4.8. So that should be a little bit less fuel. So I'm gonna paste it. And there, like I said, guys, there may be a easier way to do this. And now I'm gonna go in here, and I'm gonna left click it, highlight it, right click it, and fuel selected values. And then we're gonna get, this is probably gonna be a little rich, man. I'm gonna go ahead and lean
but
this
we're
up.
Just,
I'm gonna go ahead and just lean this up just a little bit. You're just trying to get
Yeah, we're just getting rough startup anyway, and then it's going straight to the dyno once we find there's no leaks.
So I just pulled out 10% of fuel there, and that might be a little much, but we're gonna let Holly Jesus take the wheel here too. So now we got our zeros, where we're pretty close on our zero, right? So we got our, this is our zero, this is where it's in vacuum. These numbers are probably gonna be a little excessive. It's probably gonna be a little fat initially. But so what I'm gonna do now is I know this 24 up here is pretty close. It's a little bit leaner than what it was. That was because that was our 22. So I'm gonna fatten this one up. I have not fattened that one up yet. I'm gonna fatten it up 5%. So that's not much. But so now I'm gonna go here and I'm going to highlight down to the zero, not all the way there. So this value here, all the way down to the zero, which we just done. So we know this one is gonna be pretty close. And now we're just gonna fill. We're gonna let Holly do his thing. We're gonna let it fill in the blanks.
Look at that.
So it filled in the blanks. So it built our fuel map here. And now this still looks funny, right? Because we still got a zero up here. So this was your 22. So now up here, the very top one was 31 pounds. So we're gonna take this very top one. So that was our 31 pounds. Did we ever make that much?
I have no clue what we made, honestly.
I don't remember either. So I'm gonna cut it, and I'm gonna put it right here on this 33.8. Okay, so now I'm gonna paste it over top of that one. So that's a little bit more fuel. It's 33. I'm gonna add, since it's a little bit higher. What injectors you got?
Billet atomizer 500s.
There are billet atomizer 500s?
Mm-hmm.
See that, you know what that white dot means?
No.
That white dot means that is the injector is not gonna flow that much fuel.
Okay. So that's Holly's way of telling you that it's not gonna flow?
That means your injector is not capable of doing it. So, okay, so look, so I'm gonna just, at 33, and I'm gonna go here, and I'm gonna do the same thing. So I'm gonna fill it again. And now boom. Okay, so that's starting to look more like a map here. Okay, so now we gotta do some guesstimation. So what Kevin's gonna do is Kevin's gonna go to his Coyote files, uh-huh, and he's gonna go, he may just completely copy and paste his file because he's tuned a bunch of Coyotes.
Oh yeah.
So he can probably just go in there and just copy and paste it and bloop, stick it in there and it's gonna be pretty close. But we don't have that luxury right now because we ain't no Coyote experts. We ain't no experts.
No.
So we got a guesstimate. Okay, so at 9,000 RPM, at 33 pounds of boost, it's using 3,500 pounds of fuel. So I'm gonna just guesstimate at 58 pounds of boost. And these numbers may be completely off. If we say, how big's your turbo?
94 mil.
Never mind, we ain't gonna be up there in that map anyway. You ain't gonna ever be up here. Because that 94 is gonna max out about 1,700, 1,800 horsepower, right?
Sure. Somewhere. So you're going to be down here. You ain't going to ever be up here. But you don't want to have zeros up there. This is sometimes they build maps and they'll stop. They'll say nobody's going to ever go up there in timing and in fueling.
I didn't know they did that.
And then, well, some of your mail order tunas. They tunas too. They tunas as well. They, I don't know that they're professional tuners. They could be. They could be professional tuners, and they just say, hey, it's not going to go up there. But if you go up there, say if there's a zero or there's a lean spike up there, and the computer's going to do what you tell it to do. The computer is going to do 100% what you tell it to do. If it gets to that cell that has zeros in it, it's going to turn off your injectors. And so the computer, you got to be smart enough to make sure the computer is doing what you're asking it to do. So I'm going to just put 4,500 up here, and I'm going to just make this look pretty. And that's not going to be, actually that number will probably be more like 5,000 because coyotes are very exceptional. I mean, I'm not kidding. I'm saying that not being rude. It did it again. Fat fingers.
That's because
you got to keep it in the cell is the key. So I'm going to fill that value. So now I'm going to also, now I'm going to take that. I'm going to highlight it.
Okay, yeah, now you can start seeing.
And I'm going to come down here.
That's going to be shaped the same.
That's right. Oh, shit. Did it again. So right there is the one that.
That white one.
That's right. That's the last one we're at. And now all this whole corner is going to be white. Because it's going to say, sir, you don't have enough injector to do that.
Oh, wow.
So that's what that just means. Okay, if you ever try to get up there, there's a few ways you can crutch that. But the biggest thing is when you try to crutch it up there, what you have to do is you have to go into your fueling setup, right in here, configure custom. So your system pressure is low. So we can jack that system pressure up. And if you jack the system pressure up to 90 PSI,
then it will tell it that it flows can more. Do it, yeah.
That's right. So, but right now, that's where your base pressure is at, right? You haven't changed that.
No.
So there's no need to change it right now. And but we would lose a few of those. So now we have a fuel table that looks better.
A basic one.
Right? It's a basic. It's going to be a little fat. It's going to be fat through here, for sure. But, I mean, in order for me to tune, I mean, since I'm not a tuner, I mean, I could, sitting there in the car playing with it, revving it, I could tune that puppy right on out. But so now, and it's color coded, so you can see. This is a little drastic from here to here. So probably, you know, this one right here, we should probably just lean it up a little bit. Just to make those numbers so that they look a little better. So they're a little closer. And you can also, you can look at VE in here. Wow, that volumetric efficiency is super high. Huh. So according to this, it's going to be way too fat still. It's going to be really, really way fat. So volumetric efficiency is generally the highest number is around peak torque. So peak torque will be somewhere between 5,000, 55,000, 6,000, and whatever the RPM is. But see how this is really rich through here?
Mm-hmm.
136. That's going to probably be lower. VE is what fast is in, I think. I think Fuel Tech is in volumetric efficiency. I tune in pounds per hour, but pounds per hour I can make look halfway decent, and volumetric efficiency, clearly you're just looking for oddball numbers. Sometimes you'll have a number in here, like everything will be like these in the 140s, and then you'll have one that says 110, or you'll have one that says 200, and that means you need to go into that cell and figure it out. Why is it so different than the others? This thing's gonna be pretty rich, I would say, but I'm not real familiar with volumetric efficiencies because I don't tune in it. So this is a good starting point here. So now, so let's compare real fast again. So in vacuum at minus 4.8, so at minus 4, that was minus 4 was 14.3. That's now 17.3. So that actually needs to come down some because it's more vacuum means less fuel.
So vacuum is pretty important.
Yes.
Okay, so would you say that it would be a good idea to add a vacuum sensor to this thing?
It is. It's got one. That's what the map sensor is.
Okay, the map sensor.
The map sensor is reading in vacuum. So when this car is running, if you pull this up live and you're online with the car running, you've got a dot here somewhere.
The sensor is going to read the vacuum.
That's right.
You don't have to have a separate vacuum sensor.
You don't have to have a separate one.
I did not know that.
Now, what Kevin's probably going to do, he's probably going to give yourself a little bit more resolution in here. He's probably going to move these zeros up some and put the zeros up here and then give us more resolution, because right now we don't have much resolution, especially with the Coyote motor. Coyote motors are, we're struggling with Donald's because we're just struggling. It's a small motor. So with his, I mean, you know, you got to be able to tune it perfect while it's in vacuum or when it gets to zero. So zero is where it's going to be when you go wide open throttle. When you go foot to the floor and you're trying to spool it up, it goes zero. So that's where it goes. And as it starts building boost, it starts coming up in those cells. So that's what happens. So, you know, I may go grab my computer real fast. And I've got Donald's. I've got Donald's tune-up. But his Coyote, what's the difference between his and yours?
I don't know. I mean, his ain't, it ain't as stock as mine.
All right, guys. So, we pulled Donald's. And so, I've got Donald's over here. So, his is the same thing. This is only up to 50, though. Huh. I wonder why his is only 50. Okay, regardless. Yeah, this is really fat compared to what Courtney's is. But zero. So, his zero is 37.7. Courtney's is 37.7. Are you kidding me? And then the 9,000, 788, and I wish I could just copy it and paste it everywhere.
Without right? having to type it all in.
Okay, so 48. So yours is saying 87. So that's a lot. That's half the fuel. And then the 3,400, 251. 288, 138, 61. Okay, I'm gonna reduce this down a little bit. What is our target air fuel ratio? That should be about right. Kevin might play with that some, but we're just messing with the base fuel. What RPM does this one idle at?
1,000, right around 1,000, I think, okay. Give or take.
So I just took that down to 58. So Donald's is at 48. And then the 1270, this is, the scaling's a little bit different on his too. So at 1270, his is at 61. 1600. Donald's 1800 is 120. That's pretty close. 2200 is 2300, 126. So this is where, yeah, this is where the blower is significantly different, because it wants the fuel. So 3900, 256. We got yours at 330. I'm gonna just lean it out a little bit there. Okay, so now if we go look at these VEs, now the VEs are down in a more reasonable number instead of being super, super high. So volumetric efficiency is definitely, it's what the motor should want, right?
Mm-hmm.
Supposedly. So now we're getting better numbers down here. That bottom number is on, obviously. It's way off. Okay. All right, so we're reasonably close here.
Okay.
So I think that's good right there. So we got our fuel into where it should be close, right? So now we got to do the same thing as spark. So look, so the spark one, remember that was 31? So now we got to put that on 58, 14.5. We need to scale it. Fuel column values. So 14 is where Kevin had like his max. I don't know what he's going to want to do. I should have just left that computer open and looked at Donald's. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to cut it from that 58 and we're going to paste it on this right here. And this 33 is where we're going to put it. So that's 14. There again, if you still had this map,
and you didn't change this, you're going to blow your junk up. Not only is it going to be lean, instead of having, say, at 30 pounds of boost where it had 14, now at 30 pounds of boost, it would have 21 degrees of timing. So now you got 21 degrees of timing and lean. Maybe it'll just cut off, but most likely it's going to be putting holes in the tops of pistons.
Yeah,
so, you know, that's a bad thing. So let's look real fast again. So we want to, I'm going to do this the same way. So his is 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So 14, that 15 was at, if you look at, that was at 28. So 28 is 15, that's 29. That's pretty close. So 15, 16. And he's, like I said, he's going to probably go in there and modify this too.
Yeah, the point of basically to get the startup tune, so right, that you can idle it at the house, so that when you go to the dyno, you don't have leaks and everything. The first time that I took the car to the dyno, I had a lot of leaks and I had a lot of stuff that I had to work around that was not tune related.
So you had 30 at 0.7, and then basically from there, I'm gonna just fill these.
So again, this is not a race tune, a That's dyno right. tune, or nothing like this. This is a startup tune to check for leaks.
So now at 9.7, he had 23. At 9. Actually, that was 9.9. And now at 9.7, we got 22. And so now this is basically like his old tune, essentially, give or take. And so at 58 pounds of boost, let's just, I mean, you're not going to drop down to 10, but we're going to put it down at 10 just because he may want it there. So let's go 10, and then I'm going to just go in there and just 14. I don't know what my motors want, so I'm going to just put it safe. So there's your timing map now. So from 33 pounds down, this is what it was with the blower. Now, blower is there again. It's a little bit different, different amount of heat, different, you know, the way it loads the motor. So the turbo may want a little bit more timing. But so this is a basic timing map now. So now, and there may be easier ways to do this. I mean, like I said, I'm not a professional. It takes me a longer time than most probably to do this. But now we've got a basic fuel map. We have a basic timing map with the new 5-bar. So now he'll be able to take this tune, load it into his car, and when he loads it into the ECU, all this stuff will be right. With the timing, with the fueling, it'll be close. And if he has a problem, like if he gets it cranked up, and I'll work him through it on the phone. A lot of people do Team Viewer, and that works fine too. But if there's a problem with it doing something, then, you know, it'll be okay. So one thing I am going to do is I'm going to clear this learning table because that is no longer applicable, right?
Because yeah, that learning table is for the blower.
For the blower, right. So
we want it to learn fresh.
That's right. So we, and it will. And so we'll go into your closed loop here. And we don't allow it to give it, it's got this zeroed out. So when it's in high vacuum, it's not really able to do nothing. It's in closed loop all the time. Able to learn. We can do 10% learn. I'm gonna put these down at 5, Courtney, on the bottom here.
Mm-hmm.
If we start having a problem with it in closed loop doing something funny, then you can see where you would go back and put those in 0.
Back to 0.
But we want to let the Holley be able to help us.
Yeah.
Right? That's why you have an oxygen sensor. That's why, I mean, EFI is EFI. It's able to control and help us. So instead of us with a carburetor going in there and changing jets mechanically, this can alter the pulse width of the injector to make it do what we want to do. That's it. You're set.
Good to go.
I think.
So again, all that is the very basic stuff. So this thing will idle inside the garage. That's it, to find leaks, oil leaks, fuel leaks, and all that. Then Kevin will more than likely go over all of it, change it all. Kevin, if you're a TKM customer, you got TKM motor, you're doing TKM dyno, he'll also shoot you a startup tune. I just decided at this time, John's perfectly capable of this. We'll do something very basic and just not plug Kevin. He's got a lot going on already like it is.
Yeah, this will be fine for, like you said, getting it started up, getting it running, maybe even doing some spool testing.
Yeah.
Because when it goes to Kevin
is... tune it.
That's right. It needs to be able to idle.
Yes.
It needs to be able to go wide open throttle. Yeah. And it needs to be able to try to spool.
Yeah.
And that's what it's got to do. Because He shouldn't have to go and build a complete base and say, okay, well, this fueling at 2,000 RPM and load is cutting off. You know what I mean? He shouldn't have to do that. The goal when it goes on the dyno is for him to make pulls on the dyno because his time is valuable.
And you're paying for his time. If you're paying for dyno time and if your buddy's not doing it for free or whatever, then the more stuff you could do at your house like this,
that's right,
the faster the dyno trip's going to go.
That's right. That's
and
exactly
we'll probably right. do the spool test, like I told you. I'll probably honestly load it up and bring it to Brian's.
Okay.
When you're already working on your car over there.
Right.
And then that way we can just make sure it's all right. We'll just back it out the trailer, you know, just like Donald that's does. Right. Or if you come down to Wilmington, we'll get together.
Yeah.
And we'll do a spool up test, and you can fine tune a little bit more to get us a little bit more ahead, and then we'll send it to TKM.
That's right. That's what we need. We need a couple hours with it before it gets to Kevin, so he ain't got to spend a couple hours doing this.
Yeah, for sure. And all then right, cool. we can show y'all how to do all that. But that's a basic startup, so that's gonna be this video. And then we'll see what happens. We'll throw it in the computer and then we'll get a startup this week. Thanks, y'all.